A very good evening to Dr. Mohammed Haikal and my fellow friends. So today I'm going to present about decomposition process. So before that, my name is Michalini Balasingham and my metric number is 192794. So here we go. Decomposition process. What is decomposition process? So generally, you guys know, right? Decomposition means if, for example, if an animal died, it will undergo decomposition process, which is also called decaying process, and it will become into small fragments or pieces, right? Hands apart, legs apart. So something that break down into smaller pieces is called decomposition. Maybe it will become into smaller fragments or new products, right? So in petrochemical or in refinery, in scientific term, decomposition is a chemical reaction where heavy molecules or heavy hydrocarbons will break down into a lighter hydrocarbons, which is more valuable, economically valuable products, right? Such as gasoline, naphtha, okay? So this is the general idea about decomposition process, and all the process under decomposition process have the same general idea, only the parameters and condition will be changed. Okay, so next, firstly, okay, these are the types of process under decomposition process. There are three main types of processes, which is cracking process, whisk breaking, the last one is cooking process. Okay. So firstly, we're going to learn about cracking process. So guys, what is cracking process? The word itself tells us something. It's something about crack, right? Crack means breakdown or splitting. So cracking process is a complex organic molecules such as kerogens or long chain hydrocarbons will break down into simple molecules such as all the valuable products, you know, right? Gasoline, naphtha, LPG. So this process will undergo a carbon-carbon breakdown. So the bond between the carbon atoms will break. So it becomes into smaller fragments. This is the basic information about cracking process. So the rate of cracking and products, the end products, depends on the temperature and the presence of catalyst. So a large alkene will break down into a alkenes, a small alkenes. For example, isobutane will become alkylates. So you guys know, right? In alkylation, isobutane will become alkylates. Actually, it is a type of cracking process. Alkane will become a useful alkenes. Okay. This process requires high temperature, and this splitting of molecules is influenced by the heat, presence of catalyst, and also solvents, type of solvents. There are two type of process involved, which is pyrolysis and destructive distillation. What is pyrolysis? The word pyro means fire. Lysis means separation. Okay, so pyrolysis is a thermal decomposition of a material at elevated temperature to convert heavy hydrocarbon to a lighter hydrocarbon. Okay, understand? All right. So under cracking process, there are three type of processes, which is hydrocracking, catalytic cracking, and thermal cracking. Thermal cracking. So what is thermal cracking? Thermal cracking. Thermal means something related with heat, right? Cracking means splitting or breaking. So this process is related with breaking down of something using a heat. Okay? So thermal cracking is used to upgrade heavy fractions or to produce light fractions, such as burner fuel or petroleum coke. There are two temperature range in this process, which is a high temperature process and another one is milder temperature process. For high temperature process, guys, example of process that undergoes high temperature range is this
No waste stripping.
Yeah, waste stripping. Also known as steam cracking. No, sorry. Steam cracking, which is also known as pyrolysis. Sorry. Not waste breaking, guys. One of the example of high temperature process is steam cracking, also known as pyrolysis. And the operating temperature is around 750 degrees Celsius to 900 degrees Celsius, and can be more than that also. For milder temperature process is a delayed cooking, and the operating temperature is 500 degrees Celsius. Normally, it will produce petroleum coke. You guys know, right? Delayed cooking process will produce petroleum coke, which is also used in electrode production in steel or aluminium industries. So this is extra knowledge. So next, catalytic cracking. So the title itself will give you a brief idea what it is all about. Okay, so catalytic cracking, same breaking down of something using catalytic. The word catalytic means catalyst, right? So what is catalyst? Okay, I know there won't be answer from you guys because this is a online class. So catalyst is catalyst used for speed up the chemical reaction by providing an alternative path with lower activation energy. So this is catalyst. So in this reaction or in this process, there will be a solid acid catalyst will be used, such as a common catalyst is silica alumina and zeolites. These catalysts will promote the formation of carbocations, which will undergo rearrangement process, and then it will break the carbon-carbon bond. So there will be no, it's not like no temperature needed. Temperature is needed, but in small amount compared to thermal cracking, because the work of heat will be replaced by catalyst. Catalyst will do the same work, which is to break down the carbon-carbon bond by the synthesis, which is formation of carbocation, rearrangement, and then breakdown. Okay? So under catalytic cracking, there is a fluidized catalytic cracking process, which is commonly used in refinery industries. Initially, they used alumina in this process, and it is low active, and then they changed or replaced with zeolite, which is highly active. This hot catalyst will vaporize the feed and catalyze the cracking reaction that break down the heavy hydrocarbon, which is longer chain hydrocarbon, into shorter chain hydrocarbons. Okay, alright. Next is hydrocracking. So for hydrocracking, so same, the word hydro means hydrogen, cracking means breakdown. So hydrogen, something, they added hydrogen gas in this process to break the carbon-carbon bond. So the major product of hydrocracking is jet fuel, jet fuel and diesel. So this hydrogen gas, the function of hydrogen gas that added is to remove sulfur content, impurities, contaminants, heavy metals, and also to increase the cetane number of fuel. Okay, so next, waste breaking. Okay guys, before this, the title of the process itself tells us what the process about, right? If, for example, catalytic cracking means something related with catalyst. Thermal means something related with heat. So what you guys can understand from the word waste breaking? So you guys got any idea? Okay. So waste breaking means, waste means viscosity. Breaking means, you know, right? Breaking down. So why waste breaking? Because for heavy crude oil having high viscosity, light crude oil will have low viscosity. So viscosity breaker means that process will break the viscosity, which is the high viscosity from the heavy crude oil to become a low viscosity light crude oil. That is a general idea. Okay, So this breaking process will reduce the quantity of residual oil produced in the distillation of crude oil, and it will increase the yield of more valuable middle distillates. A whisk breaker thermally cracks large hydrocarbon molecules in oil by heating in furnace to become a lower viscosity, and it will produce a small quantity of light hydrocarbons. The type of light hydrocarbons are LPG, gasoline. Okay. So in this process, no catalyst is needed. So this is a non-catalytic process. So yeah. Okay, the operating temperature is from 450 degrees Celsius to 485 degrees Celsius, and the pressure range is from 3 to 10 bar. Next is coking process. Coking process is it involves the conversion of residual oil from vacuum distillation column into a low molecular weight hydrocarbon gases, such as naphtha and petroleum coke. It will thermally crack the long chain hydrocarbon into shorter chain hydrocarbon, leaving behind the carbon. That carbon in the form of petroleum coke. There is two type of petroleum coke, guys, which is first one is fuel grade, another one is anode grade. Yeah, fuel grade and anode grade. Fuel grade is low in sulfur content and metals. Anode grade is high in sulfur content and metals. So under coking process, there are two type of process, which is delayed coking and fluid coking process. For delayed coking process, heating of residual oil at thermal cracking temperature in a furnace with multiple parallel paths. A continuous steam is added to this to the process. It is to prevent the cooking happen in the heater. Okay. For fluid coking, fluid coking is a continuous fluid bed technology. The coke particles will be circulated to transfer heat to the reactor. So the reactor will break down the bond, carbon-carbon bond. So, yeah, that's it, guys. So the process decomposition is all about breaking down heavy hydrocarbons into a lighter hydrocarbons, which is more economic value, valuable products. So only the parameters and conditions will be changed. Okay. Other than that, the main idea is the same. So I hope you guys understand. So that's all. Thank you so much. Thanks for listening. Thank you.